What is going on, guys? This is the third episode of the Temporary Immersion Bioreactor series. If you are new to the series, we have 10 temporary immersion bioreactors and filling up one at a time every 2 weeks. We are also testing different flasks and see which one is the best for each plant. I already made media for this video. If you want to see how to make tissue culture media, check the other videos on the channel. Today we are going to use Drosera capillaris, a carnivorous plant, so I had to make 1/3 MS media with 1 ml per liter of EBA, 0.1 ml per liter of NAA, 1 ml per liter of PPM, 25 grams of sucrose, 8 grams of agar for one set of flasks, and 3 grams of Gellan gum for the other set. The flasks are the same as last time. Baby food jars, 250 ml plant cell technology pente flasks, magenta boxes, and 16 ounce deli containers. Each flask we have one small plant, and we will make a 10 week comparison to see which one grows the faster. Will the plant grown in the temporary immersion bioreactor grow faster, or one of the other flasks is going to do better? Do you think the plants grown in the media with Gellan gum will grow faster than the plants in media with agar? Let me know in the comments. After moving all the plants in the flask, I sealed all the flasks with a paraffin or saran wrap to prevent contamination. I label them with the name of the plant, date, agar or Gellan gum. Here are the plants, 16 ounce deli containers, media with Gellan gum on the left and agar on the right. GA7 or magenta boxes. Gellan gum on the left and agar on the right. This plant mover to the side but is okay. 250 ml plant cell technology vented flask, Gellan gum on the left and agar on the right. Baby food jars with magenta big caps, Gellan gum on the left and agar on the right. I also want to give a quick update on the bacopa we did 2 weeks ago. They are starting to grow new shoots and it's too early to tell, but I think the plants in the Gellan gum had a slight advantage. I think this plant in the vented flask is the one growing the fastest. It is quite challenging to take a good video of the plants, but I think as they grow bigger, we are going to be able to see a clear difference. The plant growing the slowest so far are the ones in the deli containers. We'll see if that continues as time goes on. The plant in the temporary immersion bioreactor is catching up. It started slow, but that was my fault as I burned part of the stem with the forceps. But you can see it's growing new shoots. The current setup for the bioreactors is 5 minutes soak every 12 hours. If the plants get too dry, I may go for 10 or 8 hours. This current setup doesn't allow for a quick soak every couple of hours, as I would have to upgrade the air pumps. Some people are quite interested in me showing how to build a DIY temporary immersion bioreactor. I'm currently looking for the materials and I will get it done in the next few weeks, so make sure to subscribe to the channel and follow us on all social media. In the next video, we are going to do some experiments with plant glow regulators.